So in this video, I'm going to show you how to draw the normal. Okay. So what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to show you how you would draw the normal, and also some thoughts behind drawing the normal. So usually in the word problem, you find a particular probability. Let's say you had the probability of X being greater than or equal to, let's say, 20. And let's say that the population mean, well, let's say that was 30. And the population standard deviation, let's say, was 10. These pieces of information are very important in creating a normal. So I'm going to draw a line, and I'm going to name it with my random variable, x. Okay. And this might not be sufficient, but we'll see if I'm able to have enough space for my number line. First thing I want to do is to draw 30, which will be, let's say, here. 30 is my mean, and that's where my curve will be drawn, right? Well, that's horrible, but that's the idea. There's some point here, right? Some point, the top part of the normal, and somehow it bends right down. There's some other point as well, an inflection point, right? There's a vertex, right, the top point, but then there are these inflection points, meaning that the curve is going, you know, going down perfectly, and it shifts and curves, right? That pivot point. Where are these points of inflections? Well, first of all, where is this, you know, particular point? The top portion of the normal. Well, that one's easy. You know where that is, because it's right at the top of the true mean, which is right here. We'll say it's over here. Okay, now, again, we have this curve, right? And there's some inflection point. Where are they? Well, it turns out that these inflection points are about one standard deviation from the left, and one from the left and from the right. So negative one standard deviation from the left and one standard deviation to the right. That's where your inflection point is, okay? And that would be your value, your first standard deviation, one standard deviation away from the mean. So if that's the case, then this would be 40, because the standard deviation is 10, so you would add 10 to 30, right? And of course, that would give you 40. And then you would be two standard deviations away, right? And that would give you, you would add another 10 to 40, or you would add 20 to 30, because 30 plus one standard deviation plus another standard deviation, and then that would be 50, right? And then usually on a normal, you have three standard deviations, right? That would be 30 plus another 10 plus 10 plus 10. One standard deviation, two standard deviations, three standard deviations. So that would be 30, 40, 50, 60. So 60 would be over here. That's really messy. But that's the idea. And of course, you would also do it the other way. So let me erase this here. Okay. So we're going to draw a dot at one standard deviation. So how far is that? Well, in this graph, we'll say that every two spaces here is 10. So this will be 40. So this will be 40, two more spaces, 50, two more spaces, 60. And then the other way. Two spaces down, right, will give you 20, two more spaces down, will give you 10, two more spaces down, will give you 0. Perfect. So, again, we have this curve, right? Somewhere it bends, right? This is an inflection point. Where is that point? What's one standard deviation away from the mean? And how far away is one standard deviation to the right and to the left? That's right, 10 away. 10 away from 30. So you would draw a dot somewhere around here. And then another dot over here, asymmetrical. So you can see that it's one standard deviation to the left and to the right. A curve. Right? Maybe we can draw it a little bit better. Okay, that's pretty close. That's the top portion of your normal. And then, what do we do? And then we need to do the tails, right? So, this piece right here is this way. Now it needs to go that way, right? So how do we do that? Well, we draw it. And what we're doing is we're aiming here while we're going down. That's about right. Now, this line at three standard deviation is getting very, very close to the x-axis. It never crosses or never touches it. So make sure you don't do that. And then we're going to draw it on this side as best we can. And that's pretty symmetrical. Not perfect, but pretty good. And what you can do is you can erase, you know, these dots. It's not a perfect drawing. Some people can draw it very well. I can't. But that's not bad. And if you wanted to keep going with this, right? What's the probability of x being greater than or equal to 20? You know, it would be here, would be the line, and then you would shade it. Now, I have another video I'm going to show you how we do that. The probability of, let's say, z is less than or equal to 1.84. Now, here, the random variable is z. So we know that there are z values, z-scores, z-table, standard normal. And what is the standard normal's population mean standard deviation? I'll give you a minute, less than a minute. That's right. The population mean is going to be 0, and the standard deviation is going to be 1. Okay, so just because I knew that the random variable was z, or z values, z scores. What I'm going to do, this is a standard normal curve. They're all written the same way. Okay, so here's my line. Maybe we can draw a little bit better. And at the middle, right in the center, is going to be 0. That's my population mean, right? Question is, how many numbers do I write to the right or to the left? Most normals, right, only go up to 3 standard deviations. So in this case, I'm going to write 1, 2, 3. And I spaced it out using 2 blocks. Same thing over here. This is going to be -1, -2, and -3. Okay. Now, it's the same idea. The question is, where are, you know, it's going to be something like that. How can we draw it a little bit better? Well, first of all, we know we're going to need a dot right there, right above the population mean. And then we want to be 1 standard deviation away, right, from the mean. This is the mean. We want to be 1 standard deviation to the right, 1 standard deviation to the left. Now, the question might be, well, where do you draw these dots? Do you draw them here? Do you draw them here? Well, you get a sense. I mean, for example, if you draw them there, it's going to be kind of a little bit harder to draw, maybe. If you put them too low, then it's going to look kind of funny, right? You gauge it. Okay, at this particular time, you're beginning to understand how to draw these things, and you gauge the dots, and then we draw the top part, right? This is some type of vertex, right? The top part. And then we draw the last piece. Again, that's this, right? And now we're drawing the bottom part. And so it changes direction. And well, that's pretty close. Again, we don't want to cross the line, right? It's very close to the line. Same thing over here. And draw it there. Maybe. I don't know. Again, you try to do your best. And then you can erase these over here. Okay. And as you probably already know, right, the empirical rule, when you're 1 standard deviation away, let's draw in a different color here. We'll draw it with the orange. When you're 1 standard deviation away from the mean, right, 1 standard deviation from the right, -1 standard deviation to the left, right, this area right here, that's going to be 68%, right? And when you are 2 standard deviations away, right, 2 standard deviations away, you're about, right, about, it's a little bit more, but about 95%. Okay, this is not the correct value, but it's an estimate, and it's really 1.96 or something like this. That's where 95% on both sides, -1.96. But, you know, for an estimate, remember, this is a stats course, right? We're estimating. We're trying to kind of like keep these numbers in our head, okay? Of course, when you take an exam, you have to be more accurate. And then when you're 3 standard deviations away, when you shade it, right, all the shade, this is about, 99% probably, okay? And we're going to talk about shading the normal. Now, one thing that I missed here, right? This is the random variable of z, right? Z for the z score, right? For the random variable z, so that you can look it up in your z table. So this gives you kind of like an understanding on how to draw a normal, right? A regular normal, and also how to draw a standard normal using two values, right? Population mean and standard deviation. And as you know, you only need two pieces of information to draw the curve. And what I just was demonstrating gives you an idea, a sense of how to draw these.